Hey, what's up, garden friends? Jeff here, Tropical Plant Party. How's everybody doing? I hope you're good. I'm great. Doing things kind of old school here, filming with my phone, which isn't ideal, but it's very humid, and I've been waiting like a solid 20 minutes, and my camera just, the fog, it just won't go away. So here we are. This is just going to be short, an update kind of video. I don't really have plant things that I'm going to be doing here. With my last video about my surgery and everything, there have been so many comments and emails and messages on Instagram and on YouTube, people asking me how I am, which is so kind and I appreciate it. And I just thought it would be a little bit faster to go ahead and just give an update and say hello and thank you to everybody in a video. So here we are. The surgery on my shoulder went well. Just to give some background, I hadn't really talked about what was going on because I wanted to get through everything, and I didn't want to have information out there where people might offer medical advice that could be harmful to other people, and just other reasons. But what happened is I had a cyst. It was a little cyst. They did a biopsy. It was infected. Everything was fine, but had to wait for the infection to go away, which took an incredibly long time, and then the infection went away, and then it took a long time to get into the dermatologist. By the time I got into the dermatologist, it had grown huge. And I mean huge. Like, probably about the size of my fist. So I get into the dermatologist late February, and he says, okay, you need to go straight to a plastic surgeon, get this off of you. So I get into a plastic surgeon, and the plastic surgeon, turns out they take my insurance, like my provider, but not my insurance. So I was like, whatever, just do the biopsy part of this because that was the first step, so at least I can clear my head and know everything's okay there, and then I'll, you know, either just pay out of pocket to get this done or whatever. So they did the biopsy, everything was okay there, but then the COVID shutdown happened, so I was left with these stitches in my back, which just really, the biopsy plus the stitches really made it grow much faster, to the point where, I mean, it was about the size of a cantaloupe. It was very uncomfortable, and it was a really sucky few months. So everything opened back up, and then I finally got into, hey Tuck. Hi Tucker, you're so cute. I love you, Tucker. So I am able to get into a different plastic surgeon because it had grown so much that I was like, I want, you know, need to stay with my provider, and my provider was like, you need to go to Barnes, which is a better hospital than where I would have been with the other plastic surgeon. Anyways, they weren't able to get me until June 17th. I begged, pleaded, and checked around with other doctors. They're still the earliest I could get in, and I wanted to get in with this specific doctor because he's very good. He sees me on the 17th, says, okay, this has got to go. They scheduled me to get this thing removed the next day. So they removed the cyst. It was kind of a scary process because he didn't know what was going to happen because he had to get in and see what everything was like before he would know how he could put me back together. So I had never been through surgery. I was really nervous. And then I was going into surgery not knowing what the outcome was going to be because he didn't know. So I was like, well, I'm going to wake up, but I don't know what's going to happen other than the cyst will be gone, which is, I mean, ultimately what I wanted. So there just wasn't enough skin to put me back together. So there's currently about roughly a 5-inch circular hole over my shoulder blade. And I was scheduled to get a skin graft over that Friday. And you can see these are all the reasons why I'd been explaining, like, I have to take it easy. I can't move my shoulder because I didn't want this giant cyst to come exploding out of me. And there was some concern about potential infection going on. I'm sorry things are shaky. I don't have a tripod for this setup here. Maybe I can stabilize my arm over here a little bit. And then have to keep the area dry. I don't want sweat around it because sweat and bacteria and infection. So I'm still in that boat because there's a giant gaping hole on my back. And even after the skin graft, that's the way things will be for a few weeks. But, so it turned out that I needed 2 surgeries, and, anyways, that surgery that was supposed to happen has been delayed because, the biopsy from removing the cyst came back, and they found cancer, pyelomatrical carcinoma. It's extremely rare. Doesn't have like a bad or necessarily good prognosis because there's not much information on it. There's like less than 200 or 300 cases reported ever. But it's the kind of thing where they're going to go in and take out more skin and more some muscle tissue to make sure that it's all gone. They're going to biopsy my lymph nodes and to check and make sure it hasn't spread, which it seems unlikely that it has since I have two biopsies from the past that didn't show any cancer. There's a possibility that the first plastic surgeon back in March maybe just didn't get a sample from the right spot, but my dad was with me in the room when he took that biopsy, and he said he took out a lot of stuff to biopsy, so it's probable and hopeful that this is something that's just developed over the last few months out of that. I mean, not saying it came from the biopsy and the irritation, but just as things progressed and got more extreme, that I'm hopeful, and it seems probable that with two other, you know, biopsies that were fine, that chances are this is very new. So it likely hasn't spread, and it's from everything I found, it's a cancer that can be controlled. You just gotta basically just keep digging away at you until it's all gone, and then, you know, you go back and get checked, and if it comes back, then they just dig out some more, and they just kind of keep doing that. It's just, you know, it's one of those things where they need to make sure it hasn't spread. And I obviously can't get my skin graft until I get through this portion of everything. The other treatment is radiation, and I don't know if they would radiate skin grafted areas. I'm kind of flying in the dark here, because the way things are with the pandemic, and it just takes long to get into the doctors. There's going to be an oncological surgeon who sounds fantastic, who's going to be in on the next surgery, guiding the plastic surgeon, like they're going to be doing that surgery together, and she is consulting with a whole group of oncologists through Barnes, who are with Washington University Medical School. Like, they're going to be some of the best minds in the country making up the decisions about what needs to be done here. So that's fantastic, right? That's all great news. And it's possible that when they did that, remove the cyst, that, I mean, all of the cancer could have come out with that alone. It's a type of cyst that forms in the hair follicle. And that's why they need to go in and keep digging. They'll remove some muscle tissue and then more from the outer perimeter, so that hole that's in my shoulder blade will be bigger, but I don't care about that. Obviously, that's, you know, I'm not too concerned about scars and things like that right now. So yeah, there's going to be at least two more surgeries, the one to remove more tissue and then to do the biopsies and check and make sure that they've gotten it all, and then to make sure that it hasn't spread. And then, assuming everything's okay, then there'll be a skin graft next week. Or not next week, the removal is next week, the week after. Then my plastic surgeon said that's when they'll do the skin graft. So it's unfortunately a cancer where there just isn't much information on it. So there isn't much I can say other than it doesn't seem to have a very high mortality rate, which is great. But, you know, it's one of those things where the information's all over the place, but one of the nice things about it being rare is when I Googled it, it's not like there's tons of terrifying information. It's pretty much all medical journals. Like, there's just not much out there about it. But the majority of what's out there doesn't make it seem like I need to be terrified. But like with any other form of cancer, you know, my big concern, I don't know what the hardest part is. It's only been a few days, but it's waiting for results is where I'm at right now. That's the hardest part, is being like, well, do I have this? Has it spread? I mean, I had it. Is it still there? I don't know. I was really torn about making this video or when to make this video. I was like, well, I should wait till I have more information. But the fact of the matter is, I'm not going to get a lot more information. I'm not even going to be able to meet or speak to the oncological surgeon until the morning of the surgery. So, you know, there won't be much to offer, and the fact matters, they don't know a ton about it either. So, we'll just go through this together, right? That'll be something different. And the other reasons I wasn't sure about making this video yet was because, you know, I like for things to be lighthearted, and it's been a pretty heavy month in the world. I mean, it's been a heavy few months in the world, but then even on the channel, I know people come here for a good time, and, you know, I highly doubt me coming on and saying, hey, guess what, they found cancer. Not really a good time, but it's the reality of what's going on in my life right now. It influences the channel, and I wanted to let people know that I am okay, but this is just what's going on right now. We'll get through it, and things pretty much stay the same as the way I was talking about in my last video, about how I have to really stay calm. One, my stress levels, they need to be low right now. So I haven't been on the internet very much, because the internet is a very stressful place. But as far as like the making sure I'm not like sweating, because I have this, you know, giant hole in my shoulder blade right now, that it's covered. Like, there's a a petroleum like gauze that's in there, and then there's a pad over it, and it doesn't hurt anymore. Things were pretty tender for a couple days there after the surgery, but for the most part it just kind of feels like a sunburn, and like every now and then there'll be like a stabbing pain, but it's not that bad. They gave me some heavy medication to take for pain, and I only had to take it twice, so otherwise Tylenol and ibuprofen's doing the trick, which is fantastic. I'm very grateful for that. And physically I feel fine. I'm a little tired because it's been a very emotional few days, as I'm sure you could understand. I almost lost it there for a second, but I reeled it back in. I'm not denying myself the moments that I need to be upset, but I'm not gonna do that here. And then the other reason I decided to go ahead and make the video was because to make this video was because I want to get back to putting out videos. It's therapeutic for me. I enjoy the time with the plants, even if the way things might be for the next few weeks is just me sitting down with the plant talking about it, because I can't do big projects. July is a very hot month, and not being able to sweat, that's going to be tricky. So I'll have to sit over by my table near the fan, and that's okay. You know, hopefully it's only going to be for like, I don't know, 6 to 8 weeks, something like that. I don't know. This is all me just saying positive and under the assumption that the cancer will be all gone and that it hasn't spread. And even still, I would imagine that I'm still going to want to be out here with my plants and having fun on the YouTube. So there's my life update. How are you guys doing? Oh, and I know that there are viewers out there who have been through cancer and the treatments and everything, and who can maybe offer advice or something like that. I know that's one thing that's been comforting to me, as I've been, you know, from there, like I said, there are a few viewers who I know have had cancer and have come out of it, even very recently, have like just finished up their treatments and life's going great for them, and it's very inspiring. It's very happy for those people. I'm not going to call anybody out here because I don't know whether or not people want those things to be public or private, but yeah. It just would have been difficult, I think, to make my last video, hey, I'm having surgery, and then just come back and not acknowledge it for several weeks. And if I find out something bad, making this video is going to be a lot harder, having not given the background of what's going on. So I figured, just go for it. Just dive on in and just talk about it. It's a thing that a lot of people go through, and a lot of people are healthy for years with it, and, you know, live long, happy lives. And this, like I said, this doesn't seem like a cancer that is one that I really need to be very concerned about, but it's still terrifying and scary. It being so incredibly rare, like, makes me feel a little bit better, because like I said, I'm not just bombarded by terrifying information when I get online. But it also doesn't help when you're a statistics nerd and, you know, that's not a great sample size for a lot of information. But that's why there's going to be they call them tumor boards at the hospitals, who are going to be handling this. And like I said, I think that having two good biopsies is a great sign. Other than the one bad one. So there's, you know, from early March, I think I want to say it was like around March 8th until June 18th. They removed the cyst on June 18th. That's not a terribly long time span. So I'm hopeful and thinking that the odds of that having spread are pretty low. And as long as it hasn't spread, other than this seems, from things I've read about it, seems to be one that comes back frequently, but they just dig it back out. And if this developed because of that area and the exacerbation to just it being a site with a lot of trauma in it, then it's not necessarily there for the same reasons it's been in other places. And I don't, like, statistically with this cancer, usually it's like men in their mid-40s. And it's usually a little bump on your neck and, like, sometimes your scalp. I haven't read anything about people in their lower 30s and it being a gigantic lump on your shoulder. So that's encouraging? I don't know. I just can't help being special, even when it comes to my cysts. What can I say? But yeah, I just want everybody to know that I am okay. Going through some stuff. Confident that I'll get through it. Staying positive. I know I got choked up a few times there, but it's not an easy thing to talk about. You know, I've had to call people who I've been close to over the last few days. Mostly just people who know I was supposed to have the surgery, because I knew they would be the ones
ask me how my surgery went, and then I would need to tell them. And then, you know, close family, a few people on the plant tube and whatnot. And everybody's been very supportive. And, it, you know, just it's just a waiting game. You know, they'll do sometimes with these surgeries that I don't know for sure what they're going to be doing with mine other than removing more skin and digging it out, like I said a million times. But like when you have a skin cancer on the nose and the surface, they'll do what's called a Mohs operation, something like that, where they shave off thin layers at a time and somebody's looking under a slide and basically they just keep digging until they have slides come up that don't have the cancer in them. I don't know if that's what they'll be doing with mine because it's such a gigantic area, though to my knowledge, which isn't much, or anybody's because it's so rare, it would have been contained to just the one hair follicle where the cyst was developing, ideally. So I don't know. I don't know if they're going to like shave the whole area out underneath or just where that hair follicle was. I don't know. And then they'll biopsy the lymph node. And, you know, this last biopsy or pathology they did from removing the cyst took them 6 days for them to tell me anything. So I don't know if when they actually know that there's cancer, if that will be faster, or if I'll have to wait another week to find out, because it's the unknown. That's what's the worst for me. So I'm just trying to stay busy. Like I said, I want to get back to doing plant things and plant videos because it'll be a welcome distraction for me. The formatting is going to be different, much more laid back, because I just don't really have time to give a shit right now about little silly things like the camera being shaky. I apologize, but it just is what it is. Did I just say a bad word? I think I said a bad word. I'm sorry. I'm not editing this video. There are cuts in the video because the phone has a pause button on it, which is a really nifty feature. But I might just upload this straight from my phone to YouTube. I have no idea. But we're up to date, and I do want to say thank you for all of the warm messages that I've been getting. That really, it makes a big difference. It does. It makes me smile, and I really appreciate it. Channel just hit 27,000 subscribers, which is huge. And thank you to all the new people. I'm sorry that you're getting onto the channel during a very odd and unusual time, but I'm confident and hopeful that things will return to some level of normalcy here within the next few months, ideally much sooner than that, right? I'm going to be doing a garden tour next. That's why I haven't really been walking around showing too many things. There's not a ton to update on because I haven't been able to do anything. But I have had some help out here, and I'm going to have some family coming in town to help with other things because I have all these plants and I can't just leave them out, especially like the little annuals. They'll die in the heat of July. We're almost there, and like they'll just cook. They need to get potted up and planted. So I'm going to have some help out here. So even though things haven't changed very much for the month of June, because, you know, the cyst and then the surgery and what I'm dealing with right now. But that will all change here in a few weeks. And there are a few things I'm kind of excited to show you, I think. Maybe. I can show you right now. Screw it. Oh, got a palm tree flower. I know the Floridians are like, really? Big deal. Messy seeds dropping everywhere. But it's exciting when you live someplace where they don't normally put out those inflorescences. It's just gonna... Well, it didn't look like this yesterday. So I don't know if the storms last night knocked that down or if it's just still attached. Sometimes I have had these put out their little spikes and then they fall off when we have bad weather if they come out at the wrong time. But that'll turn into like a great big cool looking torpedo thing with these really gnarly looking branches, and I'm excited because it bloomed last year for the first time, but it was at the very end of the year right when it's time to go off to the greenhouse, so I didn't really get to appreciate it. And again, I'm sorry about the shaky camera work. Oh, and I also just remembered the reason I don't film videos with this camera anymore is because the audio goes in and out and gets really weird. Crap. I hope that didn't happen in this video. It probably did. Like, it does this weird crinkly. Is it doing that? I'm so sorry if it did. Or potentially has been this entire time. Maybe I'll give it a watch before I release it. We will see. Tucker, say hello to everybody. Say hi to the garden friends. What are you eating? Well, thank you for helping with the weeds, Tucker. I appreciate it. So on that note, since I have no idea how terrible this audio may or may not be, hopefully it's been okay, I'm going to go ahead and just wrap it up here. And again, thank you to everyone. I appreciate it. And this is me reaching out. There's just too many people to reply to, so this just made more sense. And that's, everybody's up to date now. And like I said, I'm pretty confident everything's going to be okay. Don't get me wrong. I'm absolutely terrified that it won't be. But Those were very contradictory statements, weren't they? I think you know what I mean. In a lot of situations, in situations like this, we can have all the information saying that everything's going to be okay, and our minds will still spin and go places that they aren't very healthy. So that's more what I mean by being terrified, is that I've been doing my best to keep my mind out of that place. And I did reach out to my doctors and ask for a little something to help take the edge off, which I haven't taken yet, but I think I'm going to, because I haven't slept in months, because there is a gigantic cyst on my back and I couldn't lay down comfortably. And the hole from removing the cyst is no longer painful, so I'm able to lie down and get more comfortable. So that's good. I'm looking forward to getting some rest. And the weather here is supposed to be pretty overcasty, and it's going to get hot for a few days, but I actually think it's going to be pretty pleasant to be outside. So I'm looking forward to sitting down. Even I'm just, you know, this thing's telling me I reached my maximum recording time. I got to speed it up and get out of here. But like I was saying, I feel okay, you know. The emotions I'm having are, I'm pretty sure, just standard with finding out what I found out. And, you know, everything's normal there. I am resting, and I look forward to making more videos. It's not going to be like a schedule. It's going to be more like when I feel like I can, I will, which I'm sure everybody's understanding of. But it's therapeutic for me. I don't feel obligated to do it. People are always like, don't worry about it. I'm like, well, but I want to. I enjoy this. I've felt out of sorts not being able to do it the last couple of weeks. But I'm feeling better now, in spite of the cancer news that I either have it or had it. I don't know. I have no idea. But I'll know more hopefully soon, and I'll keep everybody up to date. And like I said, I don't see a lot of reason to be negative and scared in this situation. I don't see a ton of reason to be positive either, because it's just not... I'm going to be positive because it's like, why not, right? But when there's so little information, it's like, okay. I mean, this looks like it's just something they cut out and it's gone and you're okay, but I didn't fit a lot of the other characteristics, so I'm just like, you know, 2020 really can just get bent, right? I'm sure everybody out there can agree with me on that one. I cannot wait till the summer of 2021, but right now it's 2020, and deal with things head on and handle them and make the most of it and the best of it and make it all count, right? Oh, you sleepy, Toby? Are you sleepy? Okay, I'm gonna go. Hope everybody's doing well. Again, thank you for all of the support. Also, tell the new subscribers, welcome to my channel. We'll pull it together here sooner than later. It's just life, can't control it. Things happen, we gotta deal with them. Hey, Tuck, he's such a good boy. I love you so much, Tucker. What's that? I'm barely touching you. You good boy. Yeah, there's a lot of kind people out there who subscribe to my channel, and I very much appreciate all of you. Definitely making me smile during these times, which is nice. And of course, as always, and most importantly, everybody, keep on growing. Bye bye.